Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you one of the oldest Iranian art along with its classic and modern styles. So stay tuned. Persian miniature is a kind of delicate Iranian painting which in the past was mostly made for literary, scientific and medical book layouts, and today it is used for other purposes as well. After the West became familiar with the art of Oriental painting due to the similarity in size, the Westerners used the term miniature for Iranian paintings too. Iranian painting differs from Chinese and Japanese miniatures in terms of philosophy and aesthetics, and from a technical point of view, it differs from European miniatures but has some similarities in size and smallness. The art of Islamic Iranian painting flourished from 14th century to 17th century. But the carvings and paintings left from the pre-Islamic period, as well as murals, drapery art, and calligraphy in recent centuries are less known manifestations of Iranian painting. The word negargeri is equal to painting, which refers to several ways of painting in different historical periods and is related to decorating stuff, especially literary books, in which the verses were ornamented by flowers and birds or other unique patterns, or artistic works on curtain, canvas, and walls. From a lexical point of view, miniature is a French word that was used to refer to delicate and small-sized handicrafts in the Middle Ages. Originally, the word miniature is derived from the Latin word miniare, which is a kind of pigment. In medieval times, calligraphers who used this oxide were called miniature in Latin. Attributing the word miniature to ancient Iranian paintings is inadequate and misleading. The word miniature is shortened from the French word minimum natural and is equal to the small world. At the beginning of the last century, this word was introduced into the study of Iranian art, and then it became widely used. The term miniature is not only applied to Iranian painting, but also to any small and delicate work of art that has these characteristics. Iranian paintings, whether classic or modern, which do not follow the European style and have the characteristics of ancient and separate paintings, have been called miniatures. Although Iranian paintings are similar to medieval miniatures in terms of size, these two are not related to each other in terms of meaning and even visual qualities. Many years ago, an eminent artist known as Monet migrated to Asia and illustrated his most famous work, The Book of Arjang. In that book, Iranian elements were combined with native Chinese elements and created a pure style, which, according to some researchers, created Monavi art and the foundation of Iranian Islamic painting. We can conclude that the status of the face and the sitting position of the figures in the form of a lotus and the dignity and calmness of the people were influenced by Buddhist and Chinese art. On the other hand, the golden colors, colorful clothes, plain background, and golden halos around the heads are the characteristics of Iranian paintings that were seen in Monet's paintings. Later, these elements appeared in the early Islamic period. When Islam prevailed in Iran, this country was ruled by the Arabians for a long time, and traces of Iranian painting can be seen on the wall of their palaces during the Abbasid period. According to the evidence, mural painting was considered a more common and important art in Iran even after Islam. And with the conquest of the Mongols, this art faded, but the same decorative elements were transferred to painting and book layouts. Arjang scrolls, decorative motifs on pottery and murals, have a significant role in the spread and transfer of Iranian art to Islamic art, especially painting. The main tradition of writing and producing art in the Middle Islamic period was in the form of a workshop, and most painters, who were usually men, worked as a group on a work or book. These prominent people were usually the most talented and professional artists in the workshops, who were chosen as royal painters. Usually, in each royal workshop, an experienced supervisor was appointed, whose main task was to supervise the works being produced. Painters did not sign their works due to their group work, and if a work was signed, they used pseudonyms. The naming methods of Iranian painting schools are based on the centrality of the empire ruling the country or provinces. Wherever the place of concentration of power and accumulation of wealth is considered the foundation of the country's government, artists from everywhere willingly or reluctantly used to come there. This method of naming and dividing Iranian painting schools has been popularized by Western researchers and has become more or less common in Iranian studies. Some of the well-known artistic schools are Herat, Shiraz, Isfahan, and Tabriz art schools. Nowadays, there are modern styles of miniature painting that are being done on canvas, paper, and velvet. This Iranian art has become so famous that you can see art exhibitions in different countries related to this artistic method. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section. And if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.